Hello everyone, we have a jam-packed session of Less Code, More Power for you today. We are joined by Joe Griffin, and he is going to teach you all about certifications and why you should take your next certification. Stay tuned. Hello everyone, welcome back to Less Code, More Power. I'm your host, Sarah Critchley, and I'm joined by the amazing...
Donna Sarkar, hello!
Yeah, this is amazing. We're so happy to be back, and we have an amazing guest for you today. His name is Joe Griffin. You will have heard of him because you will have likely tried to or wanted to take a certification exam on the Power platform. And this is exactly why we wanted Joe on the show today, because he's not just a fountain of knowledge, but he does so much coaching and mentoring and content around certification and really like Microsoft Learn as a whole. So Joe, welcome to the show.
Hello, how are you doing today?
Hello.
We're awesome. This is like our natural habitat, I think. So this is just, it's great to have you on the show. So could you do like introduce yourself to the audience? Can you like pretend the audience has never seen you or heard of you? Can you give them your elevator pitch? Tell them who you are, what you do, and why you focus on certification and Microsoft Learn.
Yeah, sure. So hi, my name's Joe. I am a Microsoft certified professional and amongst other things based in the UK. So do a lot of work with Power Platform, Dynamics 365 on the technical side of things usually. So yeah, you usually find me coding away somewhere trying to maybe do some weird stuff in Power Platform.
Yeah, because that's it, right? So you don't just focus on certification, but I know I've seen a lot of technical presentations from you as well. So you've got a lot of things going on.
I'm just bored. I'm like a child at Christmas, and you give me something like the Power Platform, I'm just running off in all different directions, just playing with stuff. So, you know, blame the platform, not me.
So Joe, I love watching just you perform, as we call it, perform. But what is so interesting to me is how passionate you are about the topic of certifications, which, you know, some people are like, certifications are awesome. Some are like, they're boring. But you have such a compelling reason why people should get certified. And you do so much work to make it easier for people who might be terrified of testing, honestly. Like, I'm very bad at testing. So can you tell us about how you got into the certification field in the first place?
Yeah, it was sort of a bit of a rocky start. So I started off initially trying to do SQL Server certifications, just absolutely just hitting my head against a brick wall for ages. And then I started working with, at the time, Dynamics CRM, which is now Power Platform, Dynamics 365, all that stuff. And everything just sort of clicked from there, just sort of found something that worked from there. And it's sort of like, you know, once you get one exam, you sort of, okay, I want another one. Oh, I want another one. Oh, I want another one. It's just like becomes like a bit of a sort of addiction. And it doesn't help as well. We get like really cool badges. So each one you get a badge. It's just like, yeah, so why not? Just keep doing it. Get the badges.
Have you actually got, I know at Ignite when we were having like real life conferences, they actually did real life badges, right? Have you got a few of those?
No, I would absolutely love, that's like top of my swag list in terms of just like go on, you know, just waste £50, £100, buy a load of badges and then just walk around all day. Honestly, yeah.
You would have a sash, wouldn't you?
Like I can sash, imagine. Yeah.
Dynamics, Power, SQL.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, just walk across the covers. Yeah, look at me. Look at my sash. It's amazing.
I love that you started with the SQL. Like, was you trying to make your life difficult? Like, trying to get a SQL cert?
No, I'll be honest. I've got a fond spot for SQL still. I do like SQL a little bit, but those exams are really hard. Really hard exams.
Yeah. If you're not like a SQL, in fact, expert, you're not going to pass this exam. I'm looking at just SQL stuff and SQL exam, like, to opt myself out of this.
But what's so great about the business apps and Power Platform Dynamics 365 is you've got a whole set of different exams that are really great for beginners to actually jump into. So whereas before, okay, maybe you needed to be a technical expert in these subjects, but now the barrier of entry is just so much lower, and therefore the excuse not to get certified is sort of no longer there anymore.
All right, so we hear you have something to show us. What you got?
We do, yeah. So today I want to talk about some of the new certifications that have come on board for Dynamics 365. Mm-hmm. So I'm going to start by just sort of sharing my slides on here, just so we can go through it. So let's get the quick window open.
This is great. I'm so happy.
So for those of you who don't know, Dynamics 365 is basically, it's quite, sits on top of the Power mm-hmm. Platform, gives you a set of different capabilities that you can easily add on to your Power Platform system. So if, for example, you need a sales application, you need a customer service application, you can really straightforwardly you know, get this bolted on as part of your Power Platform system environment and leverage all this good stuff out of the box without needing to develop it from scratch. So you've got these two really great new exams that have come on stream that are ideal if you wanted to get into Dynamics 365 for the first time. So the first one we can see on the slide here is the CRM exam. So this is all looking at what we call the customer relationship management applications. So being able to do things such as, you know, working with artificial intelligence, working with model-driven apps, you know, doing things such as learning about the various different modules such as Dynamics Marketing, Dynamics Sales, and stuff like that. Mm-hmm. And the great thing about this, these exams is that, okay, yeah, maybe you could do, let's say, an instructor-led training session on it, but all of these exams you can actually learn yourself. There's a whole range of different modules that are sort of available online, courtesy of Microsoft. They can actually get you all the info you need to pass this exam. You just sit all of these modules on here, get to the end of it, pass the exam, and there you go. Nice shiny badge. Sounds pretty good, right? Doesn't it?
That's so epic.
Yes. I like how this is a good way to learn the product very well. Like you say, okay, I'm going to take an exam. And as you're going through exam prep, you wind up learning a lot. Like I feel more than you would learn just like randomly trying things. You have like this very specific goal.
Yeah, it's so much better than 10 years ago because you know, you've got these online training modules. They're constantly being updated with the latest stuff. You can do them at your own pace. There's no pressure. And as we'll see as well, you can actually earn XP and level up as well. Who doesn't like earning some XP?
Yeah. We all like leveling up. It's almost leveling like human levels. This is awesome because it kind of guides you. I hear so many from people that are kind of new to the space, like biz apps as a whole. I feel like people are like, I don't know where to go. Like, I don't know what I don't know sort of thing. And I feel that kind of this, especially how this is presented in your deck today, Joe, is that it kind of guides people through. It almost kind of like takes their hand or kind of pushes them from the back and be like, this is the direction that you need to go.
This is it. And when we jump in and have a look at what's on the Learn website, you'll just see how accessible this content is and stuff like that. So as I say, you've got a really nice journey you can follow. You can also do an instructor-led course as well if you wanted to, but really the power is in your hands to actually go away and learn this stuff. And what's great as well, it doesn't just cover what we term the CRM side of things. You've also got these sort of bigger ERP enterprise resource planning applications as well, which also have some relation to the Power Platform. And we've also got a new exam for that as well. So we can actually, again, get certified. We can learn some of the same kind of things in terms of, okay, what the how the Power Platform fits in alongside that. We can dive into detail and learn about things such as Dynamics 365 finance, human resources. And again, look, we've got these self-paced online learning modules that we can sort of go through, you know, so it makes it really easy for us to do this, you know, and in fact, I need to look at doing this exam myself at some point. And the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to go through these modules on here because I know they're going to get me prepared with the content. They're going to have some really great examples, exercises I can work through that's going to hopefully get me to where I need to be for these exams.
Brilliant. This is great. One of the things I know that you do from like additional content, Joe, is you almost take this and you help pad it for people. So you kind of say, this is a great place to start, but you actually kind of list out people's blogs. You list out kind of content that kind of helps with the exams as well. Because one of the challenges that I find people also have is that people sometimes don't always resonate with like either like certain kind of ways that they learn, right? So that's something that I think is really important to you, right?
Yeah. So just as a shout out for me. So at the moment, I'm doing a blog and a video series around another exam, PL400. That's for developers and stuff like that. So again, hopefully going a bit deeper in terms of the content that, you know, I guess really supporting what we've got available around this.
Yeah.
And I think the great thing about the business applications community is that there's others doing similar things as well. So regardless of which exam you're going for, there's bound to be official and community resources available for you to turn to.
That's awesome. This is great.
Yeah.
I love
so looking good so far. So all of this stuff is sort of available as part of the Microsoft Learn website. So I'm just going to minimize my screen now and just switch across to my web browser. If you just give me 2 seconds.
And for those people that are watching, like, this is like kind of, this is a great starting point, right? You may be nervous, maybe you've not taken an exam before, like kind of, especially from a Microsoft exam, like listen to what Joe's saying and hear him when he's kind of trying to guide you to kind of the learn content, like what you can do to address that. And I think Joe, like, I know you're probably going to cover this, right? But it's okay to fail an exam. Like no one's like, no one's, nothing's going to happen if you fail an exam.
So I failed exams very recently. I failed the PL200 exam. I think back in the day, my record was probably four attempts before I passed it in the end. Mm-hmm. So it's not, you know, we all fail. You just need to earn failure. And
I failed PL100 bad when I first took it, like 2 years ago. I failed it immediately because I didn't understand what a PL900. I had no idea what these PLs were, right? Mm-hmm. So I was just like, I don't understand half of these questions even. And I didn't understand the prep needed. Like, I didn't know any of this dynamic stuff before I took PL900 because I didn't fully grok, like, oh, the relationship between these things. So I often feel like the first time taking an exam is really learning to take the exam. And the second time, you're kind of prepared more. It's like job interviews. The first time you interview for a job, you may fail horribly because you have no idea what this process looks like. So
yeah,
thank you for sharing that.
Yeah, this is it. And then, you know, when you look at the page on here, you can see, okay, you get some quite formalish sort of text down here. Yeah. You know, you click on this, view this sort of skills measured list, and you're sort of looking at it going, oh my God, what's all this on here? This is just like, you know, this is impossible. You know, so that can scare people off. But, you know, if we were to bear with this page, scroll down a little bit, we can see, okay, well, what's this here? We've actually got learning paths down here that we can follow. Okay, this is interesting. So, you know, if I was, for example, to click on, let's say, this one on here, so maybe I want to learn a bit more about Dynamics 365 marketing, you know, I get a 2-hour, 43-minute learning path with various different modules that I can sort of complete at my own leisure. And, you know, the content in here is really good stuff. So we can see it's all really nicely, clearly labeled out. We can earn XP as we're continuing. I've already been through this once already, so I already got my, I'm at level 7 at the moment. I'm really close. I need to do a few more just to get me over the thing. But as you can see, you know, you've got this really nicely accessible content, you know, mixture of diagrams and things like that. And if we were to sort of continue, go right to the end, we even get a little knowledge check. So, you know, we can just validate that we know what we're talking about. We can answer these basic questions and just sort of confirm that, yep, we're on the right track of all this. And all you need to do to get started with actually doing this is just go to the Microsoft Learn site. So it's just docs.microsoft.com/learn. Log in with your account up here. As you can see, I'm logged in like so. And then we get all of the various different learning paths available to us. I can see I've got a few started on here that I can just, you know, maybe go back to later on. I can see some more popular ones down here. You know, and it's not just Power Platform and Dynamics as well. We've got Azure in here. We've got Microsoft 365. So regardless of what you're trying to learn, there's going to be some really great content on here, and it's all free. Mm-hmm. This is all free as well. You know, how good's that?
And there's new stuff all the time. And we just introduced a Fusion Devs learning path, which is for teams. It's really for teams to learn together, where you've got IT pro type people, admin, COE, team, IT. You've got the traditional coding dev, like many of us are, who live in Visual Studio. And then you've got the citizen dev, who might be an expert in, say, building a Power App or SharePoint, that sort of thing. But really, teams of people come together to solve business problems. That's the real world. It's not like one person implements a thing and rolls out to 500,000 people. It doesn't work that way. So this Fusion learning path really teaches you the value of learning together in teams. And this exam, or it's not an exam, it's more of a learning path, is something that people should do together, I think. So I'll send that over to you, Joe. We love your feedback on it.
Yeah, and another thing, just to sort of wrap up, it's not related to an exam per se, but you've also got other learn modules covering, like you just said, Donna, those sort of subjects, but also some really great topics such as accessibility as well.
Yes.
You know, so you can actually learn, okay, what do I need to do when I'm building these solutions, when I'm building these platforms, to make sure that, you know, my solutions are accessible, I'm catering to as many people as possible, and ultimately, you know, making sure that we're building accessible and inclusive solutions as well. So this is a really great learning just to go through. It's not tied to an exam, but it does really open your eyes and make you think differently about some of this stuff.
I just took it, Joe, and I learned so many new products, new features in our tech that I didn't know about. Like PowerPoint Designer was originally made for mobility challenge people, but now everybody uses it because who's actually good at UX design other than designers? So just a fascinating learn path. I thought it was just eye-opening, all the things that are in that accessibility learn path. So take it, people.
Yeah, this is almost dangerous, right? This is almost like once you kind of like follow the rabbit, you can kind of, you're gonna add so much stuff to your dashboard. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And as I say, you start to become obsessed with it, you know, and then you're collecting the badges, and then you just sort of wake up one morning and you're just looking at all your badges going, what's happened here?
Yeah.
And you're feeling great about it. So, yeah, get involved. This is really good stuff here.
So, Joe, we never let anyone go without assigning homework to the audience. So what is your call to action for our audience today?
So my call to action is that you need to make sure that you've got a Learn account set up. So get your Learn account set up today and make sure that you are sign up to at least one learning path. So if you're new to the platform, check out some of the fundamentals exams that we've spoken about today, identify a nice little learning path for you, work through it until the end, get some XP, level up, and then through that, hopefully you can then start to get a bit more confidence and who knows, maybe even sit an exam in the future.
That's awesome. Yeah. We're good.
Awesome. Thank you, Joe, so much for being with us today. Great call to action. Set up your learn path. Get addicted. Take some tests. Even if you just want to do learn paths and not want to take an exam, that's absolutely fine. Because people learn in their own ways. I find it useful to do a project to learn. Many people find it useful to go through a learn path a few different times. But find your own journey. But definitely create a learn account because all this stuff is there for free at your disposal.
Absolutely.
Joe, thank you for teaching us so much fabulous stuff. Till next time, less code,
more power.